Yeah, it's always bittersweet, you know, going against your, you know, old team. It's been a long time there, so it was a lot of fun, though.
As a defense, you guys finally held the team under 100. Was there a lot significant sign of improvement, or just kind of with them not having Booker? What was your take on that, the defense against Phoenix?
You know, being able to, you know, hold a team under 100 is, you know, you should be able to win, you know, at that rate. But honestly, with them not having Booker and us getting better, you know, it was just kind of a storm that kind of came all together perfectly.
But are you seeing signs of improvement?
Of course. Every game, every quarter, every half, you know, we're definitely getting better. Our communication is getting better. Our knowledge of each other is getting better. You know, it's times we're kind of just out there and you kind of just feel the guy, you know, you hear the guy, you know, coming and, you know, we have to switch that. You know, you have to shade or something like that.
How do you like the role you've carved out for yourself kind of in the rotation early on this season?
I love it. You know, it's right up my alley. You know, go out, guard the best guy on the court, do the dirty work, help make life easier, you know, for everyone else.
Patty called you the grit guy. It's a pretty fair assessment.
Oh, I love it. You know, whatever, you know, nickname you want to give me besides soft.
Anything but that.
What about just the general transition defense, especially as the league has kind of picked up pace? How would you guys see your improvement in that area so far?
We have to get better at that. We have to continue to communicate and learn that, you know, in transition, we don't have a man. You know, you got to kind of get back and pick up whoever's closest to you, even if a guard has to pick up a big. We just have to be, you know, knowledgeable of situations like that. You know, if Patty or Brandon gets back and they have a, you know, bigger person, we have to kind of shade a little bit more to them, or, you know, just be on heightened awareness, you know, for situations like that.
A team like New Orleans, who last year played at the highest pace in the league, and this year they're right up there again.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you can kind of play at the pace you guys want to play at, or do you think it's going to be something like what we've seen here through the first couple of weeks of the season?
You know, we can definitely control the tempo by now not allowing them to get out in transition, like you said, not allowing them to have open threes. You know, they like to get up and go. They have a quick offense. I remember that really well. They're almost like a track team. You know, get it out. Whoever gets it pushes it and goes.